Hopefully you are doing well during this tough time. Okay. In today's video, we are going to look at the participles. I know this is a completely new topic for all of you because you haven't studied this in your previous classes. But this is going to be very useful to improve your L, S, R, W skills. So let's get started. What's the participles are? So participle is this a term of non-finite verb. It may be used adverbially or as an adjective. So first of all, we are looking at the present participle. So let me make you understand, there are three types of participles. The first type is present participle, the second type is past participle, and the third type is a perfect participle. Okay, so what's the present participle is? So present participle is represented by V4. Present participle is represented by V4. And what V4 means here, V1 plus ing. Okay, if you find this ing form, if it functions as an adjective in a sentence, then this form will be called present participle. Look at the examples. I like this racing car. I like this racing car. Okay, so look at the word first. Which word consists of ing here? Definitely racing. So racing here consists of ing. Okay, so look at it. Whether it functions as an adjective or not here, you need to look here. It is what's adjective of the words which tells us more about noun or pronoun or what adjective. So it's clear here, the word which is describing your noun will be called an adjective. So here racing is describing your car. What kind of car? It is racing car. So racing, this V4 is used here as an adjective. That's why this will be here present participle. Look at the another example. C is looking at the flying birds. So looking at the flying birds. First of all, you need to look which word consists of ing here. So this is a word here which consists of ing here. Okay, now you see whether it has been used as an adjective or not. So for this, you have to see just after this a noun is there and it is describing the same noun. What kind of birds? Flying birds. So this word is here present participle. So this is present participle. Present participles means V4, V1 plus ing, that functions as an adjective will be called present participle. But it is not as easy as we have seen it here because there are several verbs like gerund and finite verb. Both consist of V4. So how will you differentiate among these three verbs whether it is present participle, gerund or finite verb? So let me make it clear, how will you differentiate among these three verbs and how will you identify them easily, how they function in the sentence. You need to look at the three examples first. Swimming is a good exercise. Swimming is the word exercise. Okay, look at the verb which consists of ing here. Yeah, swimming, it consists of ing here. Now just after this, look, any noun is there? Any noun is not there, so it can't be present participle. So just to see this word itself, it functions as a noun in this sentence. So this will be here a gerund. Nobody is swimming here and this swimming, this word is not describing any noun. So it means it is a gerund here. The next example is he dives into the swimming pool. He dives into the swimming pool. Now you see, which word consists of ing here? Swimming again. Now just after swimming, noun is here. And this word is describing here pool. What kind of pool it is? Swimming pool. So this word clearly describing a noun. So it will be a participle because it functions as an adjective here. So this is participle here. Now the finite verb. So what the finite verb? Finite verb also consists of before. So how will you identify finite verbs? If these before are preceded by any continuous helping verb. Okay. If these verbs are preceded by helping verbs of any continuous tense, then the verb will be finite verb. Look at the example. He is swimming. He is swimming. He is swimming. So just to look at this. Just before swimming, swimming is preceded by the helping verb of continuous tense. So here, this swimming will be called a finite verb. So this is a finite verb. So dear students, this was the difference among these three verbs. Means how will you differentiate among these present participle, gerund, or finite verb? It's very easy. I hope you have understood this, and you will be able to figure it out yourself. The next one is past participle. Next one is past participle. It is very easy. Past participle is represented by V3. Past participle is represented by V3. If you find V3 there, and these are not preceded by any helping verb or perfect tenses as well as passive voice. So these will be called past participle, and it's very easy to figure it out how this will function as an adjective. So look at the example. The wounded soldiers. The wounded soldiers were taken to hospital. Now you look. This is V3. Okay? Third form of the verb. And this V3 is describing your noun. This, what kind of soldier? Wounded soldier, ghail soldier. Okay? So this V3 is describing a noun. So it will be called past participle. Look at the another example. He was dragging a broken chair. Now you know what is a noun here. Chair is a noun, and what kind of noun it is? Broken. Okay, so this is V3, and this V3 is describing your noun. So it will be called here past participle. And hopefully you have got what is the difference between present participle and past participle. Present participle consists of V4 and past participle consists of V3. And present participle shows incomplete action, rather past participle shows complete action. Now the third type is perfect participle. What's the perfect participle is? Perfect participle you will find there having plus V3. Having plus V3. Students, look. If two action occurred simultaneously. Okay. Two action occur simultaneously. So the action which occur first, you need to add there having plus V3. Having plus V3. And the action which occurred later, you need to write there V2 only. So having plus V3 will be called their perfect participle. So you need to look at the examples first. Like you having rested, we started our journey again. Now you look at it. There are two actions. Two actions occurred in this sentence. Means first you started journey and second you rested. So which action occurred first? First you rested. Okay. So the action which occurred first, you need to write there having plus V3. Okay. And the action which occurred later, then you need to use simple past tense only. And what is a perfect participle here? Just we need to heed this one only. This is here perfect participle. Okay. So the another example you can see. Having closed the door, I went out. So, what is perfect participle here? You can figure it out. Having plus V3. So, this is here perfect participle. Hopefully, you have understood this. So, let's revise it again. In short, our first one is present participle. So, present participle will be represented by V4. And if the V4 functions as an adjective in a sentence, will be called present participle. Okay, but remember, gerund and finite verb of continuous tenses also consist of V4. So, what will be the difference among these all? Present participle will function as an adjective, gerund will function as a noun, and the finite verb will function as an action. This one is past participle. So past participle is represented by V3. Okay, in third form of the verb functions as an adjective in a sentence will be called past participle. But remember, this should not be preceded by any helping verbs of tenses. If they are preceded by any helping verb, they will be called finite verb. The next one is perfect participle. So perfect participle is the easiest one here to figure it out, because only perfect participle contain having plus V3. So if you find having plus V3 means this is perfect participle. So that was all about participles.